the light place, the overcast place, and the dark place. Excitement, happiness, and extreme emotions ebb and flow with normalcy and complacency. These feelings can also counter to sadness and depression. Let's call these places the light place, the overcast place, and the dark place. Most of us believe that we are chasing happiness, when in reality, the feeling of happiness will come and go in a circle, so long as we have those feelings of normalcy and complacency, and then potentially extreme negativity. The trick here is to become self-aware enough to know what's going on in the overcast place so we can minimize the feelings and the time spent in the dark place. Remember, the overcast place is not a place where you're feeling terrible or spectacular. You're not feeling happy or enlightened, nor are you feeling sad or depressed. You're average. Now, once you find yourself in the overcast place, you have two choices. Number one, bring awareness to exactly what it is that you need and take action in getting it, as difficult or uncomfortable as it may be. Or number two, continue going down the stairs to the dark place and adding feelings of guilt and shame to your life for allowing yourself to do such a thing. Getting back to the light place while you're still in the overcast place may feel painstakingly slow. It will feel like a climb of massive amounts of stairs. This is exactly why we say things like you must choose love every day, you must choose your goals every single day, because it is not easy actually getting to them. It's easy to stay there on the stairs, not really going up or down. It's even easier to walk back down to the dark place. To resist the pain of positive change means staying the same. So it's time to get uncomfortable in order to get back to the light place. This is going to require work, time, and intentional energy. It's going to require pushing past the resistance. But every time you choose to push past, it means that you're choosing to step up and step into your highest self and into your inner power. Stepping into your power means reaching out about a promotion or an opportunity rather than hoping it comes to you. Being proud of yourself and sharing what you're proud of rather than telling yourself that you don't want to be that arrogant person. Appreciating the flaws and difficult experiences that you have because they add to your story. Looking at situations as learning experiences that can help serve others rather than setbacks. Allowing yourself to be vulnerable because it's the most human thing that we can be, and letting that feeling drive you forward. Power doesn't mean status, it doesn't mean money, it doesn't mean material things. Power means influence, power means confidence. Power means being in control and also allowing the universe to work its magic at the same time. So when you begin to feel that resistance come on, when you recognize that you're in the overcast place, about to move down to the dark place, resist the urge of spending your time thinking about all of the work that it's going to take to walk back up the stairs to the light place, and think about the feeling of empowerment and triumph that it comes from taking that first right step. Sometimes when you're in a dark place, you think you've been buried, but actually you've been planted.